begin to tell the story of how great a love can be, the sweet love story that is older than the sea, the simple truth about the love that she brings to me. Where do I start? With her first hello, she gave new meaning to this empty world of mine. There'd never be another love, another time. She came into my life and made the living fine. Remember everything you see. Because time can be a blessing or a thief. I've realized that all the memories she fills my heart, she fills my heart with very special things. Angel songs with wild imaginings. She fills my soul with so much love that anywhere I go, I'm never lonely. With her around, who could be lonely? I reach for her hand, she's always there.
We've been traveling the world playing tournaments together for 10 years. We've been to cities all over the place, and as two Southern boys, you know, that's opened opportunities that we never would have had otherwise. Our business is a tough one in the sense that there's a lot of ups and downs. Sometimes we'll travel across the world and, you know, come up empty-handed in the sense that we invest all our time and money getting over there. So it's nice to have a best friend like John to, you know, be able to relate to. And I know he supported me so much, and I hope that I've been able to give you some support in that regard. It's been a long summer. Yeah, it's been a long time coming. Never thought we'd grow older. Oh, but time never stops running. It flies away. Flies away. Flies away. Time, 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 just time, just flies.
Uncle Eddie, and this is Aunt Laurie. We're more than an uncle and more than an aunt. The way I feel about Gary, the way I feel about this whole family, I cannot tell you. I'd like to say a couple of things before we get this whole thing going. This party is going to be in 3D, dining, dancing, and drinking. And I want to see a lot of it. I want to see especially you from Florida, because I heard about you guys from Florida. You know how to really party. Also, one statement, okay, and this is very serious. If anybody has a problem with these two people getting married, I would ask you to leave right now, okay, because there's not going to be any problem. I don't want to hear anything about anybody, okay? Now, I'm not a preacher, even though you called me a reverend or whatever. I'm not a preacher, so I'm not going to preach. I'm not going to tell you what you have to do tonight, what you have to do every morning when you get to go. Anyway, so I'm not going to tell you got to kiss and make up the night before and tell each other you love. I'm going to tell you something that this is very true, that my mother told me when I got married. She said, do not make a big deal from anything. Life will be a lot simpler. She only told it to me. She didn't tell it to my wife. So we have a lot of problems, unfortunately, in this.
You know, I love countless, numerous things about you. You're by far the best person I've ever met. And you told me I only had 3 minutes up here to do this, so I'm not going to list all of them. And I just love you for loving me for me. I mean, I know I'm certainly not perfect, but I know that I'm going to always work hard to be the man of your dreams.
You look beautiful.
Do you like it?
It's wonderful. Do you like it?
It's great. You like what you see here?
You look amazing. You look amazing.
Now you make me cry.
I love you so much.
I thought I wasn't going to cry. Now you make me cry. I love you.
I love you so much.
It's almost time for the perfect day.
To ensure I be the man of your dreams, here are some vows. First, I vow to rub your tired, worn-out feet whenever you want it. Whenever we went to Italy and I offered to rub your feet one day, I didn't realize that was going to be a lifelong thing.
You're so good.
Yeah. So I messed up that, and now I'm locked into feet rubbing for the rest of my life. You got it. I vow to snuggle with you on the cold nights in the bed, and on the hot nights when I'm sweaty, to stay on the other side. I vow to always listen to all of your problems and things that go on throughout your day. Your life intrigues me infinitely, and I'm into you. And I vow to always be there and into your life and what you have going on. And I vow to be a kind, fun, generous, loving man for the rest of our lives. I'm going to try to be the best possible man. I will be the best possible man for you and our future family, now and forever.
I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. And when I come home, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who's coming home to you.
I love you so much. I love you because you roll over to hug me every morning when the alarm sounds. You ask me if I want to talk about anything before we fall asleep. You hide love letters around the apartment for me to find when you travel. You'll drive through the middle of the night to surprise me with a sunrise. You dance with me in our apartment, and you carry me around when my leg falls asleep. I love you because we call every night together date night. You slowed down your pace so we could run a marathon together. You always let me have the last piece of cake. You whisper how much you love me when you think I'm asleep and can't hear you. And when we met, your pickup line was telling me you were kinda famous.
Well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's lonely without you. And if I grow old, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's growing old. But I would walk 500 miles, and I would walk 500 more, just to be the man who walked 1,000 miles.
I love you because you laugh so hard you lose your breath. It takes us twice as long to watch a show because we keep pausing it to talk. When I'm struggling, you hold me and make the world stand still. Every day, I am in awe of you and what you're accomplishing. You inspire me to try harder and be better. I love you because you're my home and my comfort. You make my heart melt every time you smile at me. I am so happy. You turned around and talked to me that night. You changed my life, and I'm so excited to be your wife.
When I wake up, well, I hope I'm gonna be the man who's waking up to you. And when I'm dreaming, well, I know I'm gonna dream about the time I had with you.
Amie, this ring is a token of my love.
I marry you with this ring.
I marry you with this ring.
With all that I have and all that I am.
With all that I have and all that I am.
Amie, as you place the ring on Jonathan's finger, please repeat after me. This ring is a token of my love.
This ring is a token of my love.
I marry you with this ring.
I marry you with this ring.
With all that I have and all that I am.
With all that I have and all that I am.
I had a dream so big you
Phyllis asked me to be her maid of honor, I was a little apprehensive, mostly because I hate public speaking. So I first want to start by thanking our sponsors, Prosecco, for making this speech possible. And although the champagne might be flowing right now, Amie and my friendship started much more soberly in law school, if you can believe that. My first memory of Amie is probably sitting next to her in 1L contracts class, where she was feverishly typing away, and the sheer speed of her typing was enough to intimidate me. And sitting there 11 years ago, I could not have predicted where our friendship would have blossomed into today. And in the last few years, we've become very close. And I would actually say that it's fair that Jonathan, Amie, and I have all become close in the last few years. We've been on a fair number of vacations together. And in fact, I'm a little concerned because we're supposed to be leaving for Hawaii next week and I still haven't gotten my ticket. But I'm sure Amie has that under control because she's very organized. So I'm expecting to receive my email tonight with the itinerary, right? Okay. Most dependable, loyal, and encouraging persons that I have ever known in my entire life. So my best advice to Jonathan is to love her unconditionally, protect her heart, treat each day as important as the one before, and most importantly, never stop saying the three most important words. Amie, you're right. So let's raise our glasses to the lovely, happy couple. I wish you both a lifetime of love and happiness filled with beautiful memories, and I hope to share many more memories with both of you. I love you guys. Cheers.
When the night has come and the land is dark, and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, stand by me, whenever you're in trouble, won't you stand by me? Oh, stand by me, won't you stand now? Oh, stand by me, when all of your friends are gone. We'll be right back.
caution signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. Kills me, makes me feel alive.
Lately, I've been playing hard. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Lately, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Lately, I've been playing hard. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars.
Take that money, watch it burn. Sink in the river, the lessons I've learned. Take that money, watch it burn.
When John first introduced me to Amie, I realized that he outdid himself. Small town Southern boy and this beautiful New York City attorney with degrees from Harvard and NYU. High five, buddy. I've had the pleasure of third wheeling John and Amie on many occasions. Amie, you might remember the time that you were out running errands. John and I were at your apartment in Manhattan, and the one thing John told me as we were drinking wine watching a football game was don't spill the red wine on the hardwood floor. Well, the fourth quarter came around and I kicked the glass and red wine goes everywhere. John and I thought we'd be all sneaky and clean it up without you knowing, but I later found out you were on your hands and knees with a toothbrush scrubbing it up. So thanks for still letting me hang around. I've also had the pleasure of meeting John's amazing parents, Larry and Rita, and his brother, Garrett, and it goes to show where his great values come from. You're both so driven and successful and efficient when it comes to living your life to the fullest, and you're an inspiration to all of us, and we really appreciate you having us here. Thanks for everything, and good luck. Cheers.
I just hope that after everything is all set and they get together, I hope we get a whole bunch of little ones. Get it? Little, put a capital L. A little ones running around all over Brooklyn. You know? I mean, that's what I'm looking forward to. Okay? Amen. Amen. That's it. Oh, we'll get an amen in there also. A hallelujah and an amen. All right.
Days run, nights fall away. Street lights guide me. They show me the way. Oh, oh, oh. Take my hand, I'll lead you home. Escape our fate.
By the power vested in me by the state of New York, I now pronounce you husband and wife. We're not finished. I made a special call last night to the polka gods, and by the power vested in me by the polka gods, you, Jonathan, as of tonight, can go all in, and I mean all in. It's legal. You can do whatever you want. Okay.